Very good morning to all of you. This is me, Sayyed Shujatullah. So today we are going to discuss about current affairs of 23rd, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th November 2018. Current affairs we are going to discuss today. This will be a very lengthy video, so I will divide this all the current affairs whatever dated here into two parts. And as of now, today is December 2. So you might be thinking that what about 26th November, 27th November till December 2. So don't worry about it. There was a function in my home, so I was unable to upload the videos. Okay, there was also a Wi-Fi problem was there, which was not yet fixed. But somehow I'm going to my aunt's house and trying to get the things done. Still Wi-Fi is not there in my home. So as soon as I get the Wi-Fi, so the continuous uploading of the current affairs will be again ensured. Fine. So today we are going to discuss a very important scheme for group 1 purpose. Whatever I have, I will discuss now on the slides. The same things you have to take down in your notes, and the same things you have to copy and paste in your answer sheet, the group 1 main student. For group 2 students and for other whatever the lower category examinations, there are lots of points are there which I will be saying you that this is you have to remember for MCQs. So that particular points you have to what memorize, that's all. Okay, so you don't have to apart from group 1 students, no one has to memorize the total data whatever is present with regard to this particular scheme. So we are going to discuss today about Arogya Shri. Okay, Arogya Shri, with the name only you can understand. It is self-explanatory also. It is self-explanatory. So it is nothing but a health scheme. It is nothing but a health scheme. So Arogya Shri is the flagship scheme. It's a flagship scheme. What does it mean? Flagship means the major scheme. The scheme which Telangana government wanted to, okay, take it. Okay, in further wanted to develop it further, wanted to in a what initiate a new what the provisions are there in the scheme. Okay, so nothing but concentration of Telangana government will be more on these kind of schemes. So thus those schemes which are very important, which are a part of the ruling party manifesto, okay, etc., they are called as what flagship schemes. Okay, you remember this point. So Arogya Shri is a flagship scheme of all health initiatives of state government. The group 2 students and other students should remember that this particular point, whatever is bolded here. Provide quality health care to the poor. Remember this point. So here what you have to remember is, it is only for the poor people, not for the above poverty line people. It is for the people who are living below poverty line. Okay, those who are poor, this particular Arogya Shri scheme will be implemented for them only. It is for, okay, fine. The aim of the government is to achieve health for all. In order to facilitate the effective implementation of the scheme, the state government has also set up Arogya Shri Health Care Trust. Very, very, very important point here. You should remember it. Okay, so to implement the Arogya Shri scheme, the Telangana government has done what? They have set up a trust which is called as Arogya Shri Health Care Trust. Okay, so please do remember that. Arogya Shri scheme is a unique community health insurance scheme. This is the actual definition of the scheme. Arogya Shri scheme is a unique community health insurance scheme being implemented in the state. Okay. The scheme provides financial protection to the families living below poverty line. That is what I have already told you. This Arogya Shri scheme is, okay, generally directed for the people who are living below poverty line. Remember this point. And up to 2 lakhs, okay, up to 2 lakhs rupees of healthcare benefits they can avail from this particular Arogya Shri scheme. Remember this point. Apart from group 1 students, the group 2, group 3, group 4, SI, constable, whatever the other examinations are there conducted in our state. So you should remember that Arogya Shri scheme is a flagship scheme of Telangana. Arogya Shri scheme is to provide quality health care to the poor. Aarogyashri scheme is a unique community health insurance scheme. Aarogyashri scheme is generally for people living below poverty line. Aarogyashri scheme, under Aarogyashri scheme, amount of 2 lakhs rupees per year will be given as it for treatment. Okay, for serious ailments requiring hospitalization and surgery. This is again a very important tricky one. Okay, means whatever the benefits that you derive from the Aarogyashri scheme, no? Okay, they're not given for fever, cough, okay, small injuries there. For that, it's not given. This scheme is not applicable for the such kind of diseases or sickness or ailments, etc. When a person is seriously injured, when he is having a persistent injury or a disease or disorder which require hospitalization, nothing but admitting. So person is admitted into the hospital and a surgery is carried out. So in these two cases only Aarogyashri scheme is applicable to that people. Okay, not for fever, cough and general sickness. So around 949 centers are covered under this scheme. 949 centers are covered under this scheme. Do remember this. The MCQ related examinations should remember this point. 949 centers are there. The objective of this scheme is to improve access of below poverty line people, nothing but poor families, to avail quality medical care for treatment of identified diseases involving hospitalization, surgeries, therapies through an identified network of healthcare providers. Healthcare provider means hospitals only, right? They only provide us health, right or wrong? They only what cure our diseases. Healthcare providers are nothing but hospitals, whether private hospitals or our government hospitals. Okay. The scheme provides coverage for various systems of our body, like circulatory system related diseases, okay, respiratory system related diseases, that is lung, excretory system, that is liver, kidneys, okay, pancreas, neuro also, any psychological disorder, pediatric, any children related disorders, congenital malformations, burns, if any burns, like a cylinder was blown just beside you and you have got lots of burns on your body. So major burns are covered here. Post burn contracture surgeries, very common thing for functional improvement. Prosthesis, that is artificial limbs, are also covered in this particular scheme. Very important this point. I hope that this particular point will be coming. Okay, prosthetic limbs, cancer treatments, either through surgery or through by the uses of chemicals such as chemotherapy or by the use of radiation, that is radiotherapy. So cancer can be treated in any of these particular methods, either by direct surgery or by chemotherapy using chemicals or by subjecting the patient with the radiations. Okay, so that is called as radiotherapy. Polytrauma, okay, polytrauma means having, if you are panicked, okay, if you are like having one was going through trauma, okay, stress like that, that is polytrauma, including cases under MV Act, and cochlear implant surgery with audio verbal therapy for children below 2 years. Always remember this point. Okay, so that's what Aarogyashri scheme is, not only directed toward the adult population, it is also covers the children's. Okay, and in children's, what does it cover? Audio verbal therapy means if they are not able to hear, if they are not able to speak, okay, what kind of treatment should be given to them. So any children who is having any listening problem, any speaking problem, okay, and the children should be below 2 years, okay, these particular children can also take the benefits of Aarogyashri scheme. Do remember this point. Okay, and here various diseases are there. You can Google it and you can know that what is a disease, for what happens, you can know the symptoms of it. I have not mentioned it because the video will be too lengthy. Fine. Now let us go to the another slide. So I've been telling you that group 1 students directly they have to copy and paste, that will finish their particular total answer itself. The beneficiaries of this scheme are the members of below poverty line. We have already discussed this as enumerated and photographed in the BPL ration card. So identification of the beneficiaries here is going to be done on what? The people who are having the ration card and available in civil supplies department database. Okay, of course all the ration cards will be there with the civil supplies department only, because they only give the ration, they only give the ration, remember this. Okay, so the benefit on family is on a floater basis, remember this point. The total reimbursement of 1.50 lakhs can be availed of individual or collective by the members of the family. An additional sum of 50,000 is provided as buffer to take care of expenses if it exceeds the original sum of 1.50 lakhs per family. So one important point that I want to mention here is Arogya Shri scheme, they are giving how many lakh rupees? They are giving 2 lakhs rupees. So it is not per individual, it is not per individual, per person the government is not giving 2 lakh rupees. So for the whatever the ration card we are having, no ration card, the mummy name, papa name and sister, brother, so all of them can avail up to 2 lakhs only, up to 2 lakhs. So it is a scheme for a family, it is a scheme for a family, not for individual, not for an individual, do remember this point. And one more important aspect of it, once any of our family member, okay, unfortunately got admitted and went for a surgery, first of all they will give only, they will sanction 1.50 lakhs only, not more than that. Okay, okay, if suppose 1.50 lakhs are also exceeded, then they will sanction the 50,000. Okay, if this is called a buffer amount, so there is a scope that you can avail the total benefit to a tune of 2 lakh rupees, but at the first installment you will get only 1.50 lakh rupees. Okay, fine. Cost for cochlear implant surgery with audio verbal therapy is paid by the trust up to a maximum of 6.50 lakhs per case. Okay, for the children's it is up to 6 lakhs because children are the future of our country. That's why the amount is sanctioned more in case of children, because they should develop well and they should be an asset to our country in that way. Okay, fine. Then whatever the transactions are there, all transactions are cashless. So remember this, cashless means you don't have to go, you don't have to go to the hospital by keeping even 100 rupees in your purse. Okay, directly you take your ration card, and the moment you take your ration card, Arogya Shri card will also be there with you. You submit it to the hospital, either Yashoda, Apollo, whatever, they will take you. Okay, if you, the diseases whatever we have mentioned are a part of the Arogya Shri scheme, and if you are suffering from that particular list of the diseases, they will directly take you without an NB. You have to spend out of your pocket. That is called as what? Cashless. A BPL beneficiary can go to any hospital and come out without making any payment to the hospital for the procedures. Okay, for the procedure, surgery, therapies, whatever, or which are covered under the scheme. Remember this point. The same is the case for diagnostic too. If eventually the patient does not end up in undergoing the surgery or therapy, hospital have to conduct free health camp, thereby taking advance evaluation to the doorstep of the patient. So suppose you might be thinking that you are suffering from any breathing problem like that. Okay, so for that you have given the Arogya Shri card. So in this case the doctor advised you that you don't need any hospitalization, etc. So in that case the hospital, what person should carry out, what the hospital authorities should carry out the diagnostic free of cost, diagnostic free of cost in the form of free health camps, in the form of free health camp. If any person in this health camp is having a major problem, then they can ask him to give the Arogya Shri card, and they can get him into admitted in the hospital and the procedure will be done. This point also you remember. Okay, all the primary health centers are nothing but very small first line hospitals which are generally present in the rural areas. Okay, one RMP doctor will be there, one junior resident will be there, one nurse, one person, minimum instruments will be there. In that only one, like two shops, like a, that's not small, small one. So, but they are government. They are government ones. They are all government ones. All the primary health centers. Okay. Primary health centers, which are at the, which are the first contact point. Okay, in any area. Okay, or the district hospitals or the network of hospitals are provided with help desk manned by Arogya Mitras to facilitate the illiterate patients. So you know, all know that the rural literacy in Telangana is very, very poor. So many of the people don't understand how to fill the form, and they don't even understand what kind of diseases they are having, etc. They cannot read things. So for that purpose, each and every hospitals are provided with what? Arogya Mitras. Arogya Mitras means health friends. Okay, health friends. So they are going to assist the illiterate patients. They will tell, madam, you, amma, you take this form and go to that particular place. Sir, you take this, and your disease is generally to in is very good in this particular hospital. You have to submit this particular proof, that proof, etc. So they are these Arogya Mitras are going to assist the illiterate patients whenever they come to any what medication in any of the hospital. Okay. The field staff, including network, Arogya Mitras were recruited through the district collectors on outsourcing basis. This is again a very important point. So the Arogya Mitras are not government, what, government servants, not government employees. They are generally recruited, okay, by district collectors on outsourcing basis. Okay. Fine. So this is the last slide. The disease specifically excluded from the list are high-end diseases. So if the question comes that Arogya Sri scheme covers all the major, minor, medium diseases, means it is a wrong statement. Okay, all the high-end diseases, the major diseases, has been excluded from the Arogya Sri scheme. Remember this point. Okay, students, the diseases specifically excluded from the list are what? High-end diseases such as hip and knee replacement, this is not going to happen. Bone marrow related anything, not going to be what treated in any of the hospitals under Arogya Sri scheme. Cardiac and liver transplantation, not going to happen under this scheme. Gamma knife procedures in neurosurgery, this is also excluded. Assisted devices for cardiac failures, okay, artificial valves, etc. in the heart, that is also excluded. Okay. And diseases covered by national programs. So whatever the central government is providing, no, all that particular central government diseases has also been excluded under Arogya Sri scheme, because you can avail that anyhow, right? So TB, HIV, AIDS, leprosy, infection diseases, okay, any other malaria, filaria, gastroenteritis, jaundice are the examples of infectious diseases. So always remember, they can ask you in the group 2, in the group 3, group 4, they can ask you in this way. Which one of the following diseases or which one of the following disease is not covered under Arogya Sri scheme of Telangana government? Like that, they will ask you the question. They will give four options. They may say malaria, filaria, leprosy, and diphtheria. So you can say that diphtheria, they can say what, chickenpox, smallpox, okay, and asthma, and they can say TB also. So TB is the one which is not not covered under Arogya Sri scheme, because these particular diseases, okay, from TB to jaundice, all these diseases are included by the central government in various national programs. That's why they have been excluded. Some common, some very serious infectious diseases are excluded, and also high end diseases are also excluded, which I've already mentioned here. To the extended Arogya Sri scheme covers the treatments, it would no longer be permissible for the BPL population to approach the government for providing relief for medical purposes. Okay, from the Chief Minister Relief Fund. Chief Minister Relief Fund. So once a person has availed any of the benefits from the Arogya Sri, no, so then he cannot apply for any of the what extended benefits from Chief Minister Relief Fund. So he is excluded. So this is all about today's particular video. The continuation of this Arogya Sri scheme, this is till now whatever we have learned. No, this is the static data. This is the static data. So on the 23rd November, okay, 2018, recently on this particular Arogya Sri scheme, there was updation is there. That updation I will be going to discuss in 1 or 2 days. Okay, thanks a lot, and sorry for the inconvenience that I am not uploading the videos, okay, very regularly. But once the Wi-Fi is fixed, everything will be settled down and you can get more and more information from me. Thanks a lot. Have a good day ahead. Bye bye.